Hi, I'm Pat Gunn, and this is part of my Let's Play series for Fallout 4. So today, what we're going to do is go and explore this portion of the Commonwealth. In particular, we're aiming to go and visit Dunwich, which is one of my favorite areas in the game. It's kind of a play on words on Dunwich Horrors, which is a reference to H.P. Lovecraft. And I think, actually, it's somewhere around here. We also haven't explored much of this part of the map anyhow, so it makes sense to go there. Before we go, I gained a level by doing a little bit of work on some of my settlements. And I'm going to spend it. And I will spend it on... Let's see, can I get armor? Carry weight would be nice. Yeah, I can't do armor. Actually, we're going to bump up our strength a little bit. Maybe. Actually, can I get sneak? Because agility would be pretty nice. Sneak would be pretty nice. Now we have the agility for it. Sweet. So that's a nice step. So our first thing to do is head out to Taffington Boathouse, which seems to be our furthest east settlement, and we're basically gonna head eastwards from there. So, off we go. So the work that we've done on our settlements, I've largely just done a little bit of cleanup on mostly uninhabited settlements. Interesting. So, we're heading northeast to adventure. We're going to be trying to use the handgun a little bit more because we have plenty of ammo for it and not so much ammo for the sniper rifle or the other things. So, I think that is something. That's one of our trade bots.
What a letdown.
Okay. Anyhow. And there's still somebody nearby who doesn't like us. Okay. But I don't see where they are. Caution mode. Okay, we're gonna keep heading east. There is another blood bug.
Safety off. I think
I'm all over this!
Damn, dude.
That was just starting to have fun.
What's going on? Looks like blue lasers. Mean that the Institute is doing stuff. I think what's happening, probably, is that some synths are going after some super mutants. we'll let them fight for a little bit while we loot this bus, and then we'll head north. I think we heard a nice big explosion earlier. Yeah, this definitely looks like interaction between super mutants and synths. Which is good for us. Okay, dead synth. Dead super mutant. And a trade bot. So probably somewhere around here is a survivor. I'm not sure who likely survived, but it's pretty rare that you end up having two foes completely wipe each other out. But spike board was not a useful thing to pick up. So we're going to get a bunch of nice map markers out of this. So this is the place where some raiders were. That on the map. This looks like... So Slocum Joe's, if I remember right, that's a donut shop chain in the Fallout universe. Which is a bit of realism in that most games you have will not have fake donut shops. Pretty cool that Fallout does. Going. And there is a distress signal somewhere nearby. That is...
Over here!
Oh my, I'm pretty sure Thunder is here. Likely we'll be back here at some point. Yes, actually, we will be back here because there's a quest nearby. Or, I mean, not nearby. There is a quest that we're definitely going to do that involves digging through there. Now, the reason I'm taking a little bit of a detour here is that I see a marker for settlement nearby. Let's save because... always sucks to be pulled way, way back if something goes wrong. Okay, we are right by a settlement. Greentop Nursery. Good. We're not going to interact with them yet, but I just want to put them on the map. Because eventually we would like to make that settlement one of ours. But we are not in a hurry to do that. Keep on moving. Don't quite remember what this is here. It looks like it's a listening post. Need to do anything with it right now. We're gonna keep on heading east. Looks like there are two possible settlements within range. If I remember correctly, one of these is not really a human settlement. It is... Uh-oh. That is not good. It's a bear. Well, it was a bear. It was a dying bear, and we were able to kill it. Like it was going after mutant hounds. Okay. We'll continue east. Over there we see... looks like a factory of some kind. Traveling traders is around here, so we will...
You have some sort of medical problem here, or are you just yanking?
Uh-huh. I need some supplies, Doctor.
I got loads of stimp.
We're gonna sell anything that we don't need. Institute rifles are actually not particularly good weapons. I don't remember why I picked that up. I do not need this. There we go. Save, and we're gonna continue. Let's see where we are on the map. Oh, we're doing... this is going quite nicely. Let's see, so to get... I think it's more or less just due east of here. Are the Dunwich borers. Well, is the Dunwich borers. I think it's that crossed... shovel and pickaxe thing. Which I suppose looks a little bit like a hammer and sickle, but not really. Okay, we've got to chill out here because we've got to be ready for... okay, let's try and mark everybody that we can on our map. Those two. Got somebody in power armor down there. Somebody over there, and somebody down there. And somebody down there who's actually doing some work. And somebody down there. Not sure if that's everybody, but it's at least... oh, and somebody over there. Okay. It would be pretty nice if we can take this person out without alerting everybody else.
Nothing there now.
Maybe we should just give up on that and alert them and then run away.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Okay.
Gotta cut down to the
confirmed these are raiders, which is a little bit weird because there's no in-game way to know that. Oh, you just had to walk. Let's see, is there anybody else that we can take care of while we're up here? If the person in power armor down there can, will turn around. Oh, gotta get that. Then we can blow up their power armor with a crit. Okay, oh, great. We did it. Okay, let's do one of those... miraculous. Okay, a nice hit, and we will back off. And it's gonna explode.
You could have sworn.
Okay, and now.
You hear that?
We have shitty aim.
Not this time!
Really shitty aim. worst thing you generally want to do in Fallout is...
You're dead! I'll just get shot!
Just kind of stand still while your opponents shoot at you. So we'll come over here, swap weapons to something that can actually fire quickly. See if we can shoot out this person's knee.
Break every bone in your body! Time!
Ooh. Okay. And there's somebody who we didn't mark. So we've marked a lot of people. is... Combat armor stuff. Aluminium can... Still more combat armor stuff. Great. Okay. Good. And down we go. So this is Dunwich Borer's company. It was apparently a pre-war quarry. That raiders have since taken over, and they're still doing quarrying. Which is different, because ordinarily you would expect raiders to be kind of the lazy sort, not the sort to be interested in hard work. Okay, this is a bit of power armor. These are the people that we sniped from a good distance. And we're really getting a fair amount of fairly heavy loot. But we've at least marked it on our map now. Okay, so we're gonna pop off and drop some of this stuff off and then return.
Last time I had green fingers.
Quite a lot of that. Now, for MacReady, I like his outfit enough that I don't normally think about putting other types of armor on him. But later on, we'll be getting another companion, Kate, who I am usually pretty happy to put some armor on. Pop off the meat. Rat chunks. Yeah, meat. Lots of heavy meat. Burdened than I would like. I'll take care of it later. Whole bunch of frag mines. I like to have some grenades on me. Most of the time, though. and for MacReady.
Hey.
Well? Time to split up the loot?
Oh, I must have emptied him of that extra junk earlier. Fast travel marker puts us at the top, so we have to run back down. Well, this looks like it might be a faster way down.
Are you impressed yet?
Hey.
What's up?
Excuse me.
So, you impressed yet? I told you I was a...
Actually, I'm quite...
Yeah. I'm completely self-taught. You always thought it was smart. Besides...
I can't imagine how to...
Well, at least lived underground. We kind of had a...
Sure.
I know, it sounds...
How could a bunch of kids...
Everyone pulled their own... Just like a colony, you'd find any.
So here he's.
Can you believe I was actually the mayor for a while?
In,
me.
In Fallout.
Crazy, I know.
Pretty brave. Bunch of kids living.
I don't know. Anyway, I took the odd job. So I hitched a ride. Made a pretty decent name for myself before I.
Right.
They were animals. I went with it for a while, which.
Yep. Pretty.
Sounds like the.
Look, I know I tend to. Nothing can. Now that we've been. I just want. Well.
Okay, so we've gotten his affinity up a little bit further, which is cool. But we're not really going to be able to do stuff until it's up, I think, one more notch. So, let's keep going, and here we actually enter the underground part of the quarry, which is something that I find interesting. This is a very narrow entrance, and it seems like there's a whole lot that you can do just up
on the
surface.
What's the point of picking
there?
Up that junk?
It does not really make sense, in my view, to have dug out this elaborate stuff down here. I mean, this elaborate area down here.
Dust is going right up my nose.
Raiders. Okay. Nothing we
can't
can do
pick
here.
This.
That requires a key. So, I'm gonna head back. Yeah, so up ahead, there are definitely some raiders. Looks like they're wearing some pretty nice armor. So, these raiders are actually doing quite well for themselves. Which maybe. Part of why.
Time to die!
Because their will is to work.
Turn up, you're...
And take him out real quick.
Wow.
Yeah, so the fun thing about this gun is that... Actually, this is quite nice. Well, okay. Yeah, it's some incredibly nice combat armor. Some nice grenades. Anyhow, what was I saying? I was kind of expecting to be finding the raiders with semi-shoddy armor, but this is some of the nicer combat armor that you can get. Pretty careful. So what I was talking about is that this is a unique handgun that when you score crits with it, it freezes your enemies. I think in lore, there were people experimenting with all kinds of crazy stuff all the time. Okay, can I safely jump down? Maybe not. It's not from there. Here, I think I can. Okay, there is somebody else.
Think you can hide?
Doing well for himself.
Playtime cover.
That might be very hard
to
okay, that looked like it hurt.
It's very hard to look directly at him. More combat armor. Wow. Okay, so MacReady.
Yeah, what is it?
I would like to actually put a mining helmet on him. Is he not going to turn it on?
Psst.
Maybe this mining helmet?
Need something?
Hey!
Well, that is annoying.
What do you
Apparently,
want?
When he is wearing the mining helmet, he is not willing to turn it on.
Now.
Or turn on the flashlight attached to it, anyhow. Bummer. Okay, so we know that somewhere out there. Let's start the party with... Oh, there's two of them.
I'll find you!
One of them is a survivalist.
Great, I'm imagining things.
We really probably
you swear I heard something here.
Okay, now we're ready for the handgun.
Only a fucking coward hides.
Thank you.
stuff. Nice little setup here. Chems, weapons.
Nice.
Sleeping bags. We're gonna take a quick nap ourselves to heal up. Yeah, so they've gotten some pre-war equipment working again, presumably. They have mining going, which almost makes it a pity that we're here to ruin their fun, because this is one of the few instances we have of somebody really, really successfully out in the Commonwealth getting pre-war activities.
Pretty sure we're not alone.
See a damn thing.
Spread out, find
them. Everybody nearby.
Shit, lost them.
Don't tell me we're going all the way down there.
Fishing rod, that's a weird thing to have brought here.
When you turn up, you're dead.
Down you go. Now quickly backtrack here. Okay, so this is Manning Station 2. This is Manning Station 3.
Thank you.
What's up?
We found. Down we go. Now we're at the bottom of the mine. We can see Bedlam's terminal. Trace T-R-A-C-E. This would match. So these, looks like these raiders are affiliated with a place that we haven't been yet in this
game. Always thought those computers were a waste of time.
Saga's Ironworks, but...
Bingo.
100% less damage from robots, that's kind of nice. Some dirty water. Blast radius is always nice to have. Some weapons and stuff, or some ammo. Okay, so they had a setup down here. Sounds like the ground shakes occasionally. And there's some ghouls down here. So they sealed off this area. It looks like there's some ghouls around here. It's not good, but we will work on. The air is wavery, which usually means there's some natural gas leak stuff going on. I have to be careful with what I pick up. Because I don't have, because MacReady is actually already full. I'm going to back off a little bit.
Keep your eyes on my back.
Dead raiders, also check.
Oh, big
guys.
Mistake! That is an interesting weapon. It is from a DLC, so we have no ammo for it yet. I typically don't end up using those weapons very much because it's too hard to get enough ammo for them to make them worthwhile. Doesn't mean they're bad. It just means that they're not economical. Okay, there's two ways we can go here. We can go left or right. Left is upwards. Let's see what's going on up here. There is...
Do a blindfold.
Okay. Let's take it. Blindfold or stealth is always good. Just avoid triggering some types of traps. Also a good thing. I think we came from down there. We're gonna continue upwards. Another raider. Dead raider. And I think this might actually be one of the ways out. So this is an exit. Cool. Now that we know where the exit is, or where, I mean, a faster path to the exit is, we can push onward. Come on, MacReady, get up.
Safety up.
Perfect.
Bobblehead. Great. That makes us harder to find. It is also always welcome. Is that something that we've been working on recently? What is this? This is a memory.
Kill.
Sweet. So these are ghouls that have names. Bradley Ramone. Tim Schutz. Well, that one doesn't have a name. And just a whole bunch of body parts and stuff. And this is another
Something
area.
Tells me that hole shouldn't be there.
We're glad that we have.
Last time I checked, we weren't a couple of Meyerlucks.
Be glad that we got that perk that lets you swim indefinitely. Okay, so what do we have here down in the hole? Cavern has a forward location, and what we find is many new. Is a particularly nice weapon. A little bit weird that all this is underwater. I guess probably before the war, it was not. And people had some way of lowering themselves down here. Here's here. Okay, swimmers. That's how we do it. Yeah, there was some kind of a ritual going on here. That's the story. Employees of Dunwich Borers, they were being used by their employer for weird, creepy rituals. And you saw a flashback to before the war, where management had a whole bunch of the better workers and they were sacrificing them with a knife. Come along 200 years later and just find a whole bunch of these guys are converted into ghouls. There probably wasn't a lot of radiation down here, so they might have been converted to some creepy, otherworldly force. Because otherwise none of this really makes a lot of sense. And this is, it's a nod to H.P. Lovecraft. which had a whole lot of this kind of stuff going on. Ancients, that were did not have humanity's best interests at heart. One of my favorite stories from H.P. Lovecraft was about somebody who I think was in a tower, and they found that everybody always ran away from them. And once they managed to escape where they ordinarily lived in the tower, and managed to get out, and get out into a large forest, and made their way through it, and they saw other people, and they were delighted, but everybody was afraid of them. And I'm, oh, looks like there's been some regeneration of raiders out here. I need to take care of that. That as a one-hit kill. Didn't even hit then. Okay. There's our second kill. Anyhow, H.P. Lovecraft, he's one of those horror science fiction writers who you're usually either going to really love or you're not going to like them at all. He uses some literary tricks that some people think are a bit of a cop-out, in that instead of actually describing the terrible things, he usually would just describe his fictional character's reaction to them. Which, at the time, was probably a pretty novel approach, in that it meant that by not actually describing things, but just describing reactions to them, you can make them seem much scarier because you don't need to figure out what your audience is going to be weirded out by. You just have to describe somebody being weirded out. But at the same time, it is maybe just a little bit too easy. And it means that if you're doing things with, if you're doing things with film, you're not, this approach is usually not going to work at all. I think we're just going to run real quick over to that lighthouse, because I believe it's someplace, I think that's another settlement. And so just having it marked on our map is going to be useful later on. Further away than I thought it was. These guys. Things that Fallout 4 has in common with Skyrim, and that if you are persistent, and I mean really persistent, goodness, okay, I forgot that place is not alone, or it's not empty, so we just marked it on our map and we're going to run off. Looks like this is a public restroom. Ready to fast travel back home. I think one of the few films that I've seen that did a pretty decent job at taking Lovecraft and making it not too abstract is a John Carpenter film by the name In the Mouth of Madness. And it did depict a whole lot of Lovecraftian things, so it wasn't quite properly Lovecraft in the fullest sense. But it did a good enough job. It still was incredibly creepy because it wasn't really... It didn't depict the nasty violence that would be easier to show in film. It's more showing you things that are really, really horrific and leaving it up to you to imagine what would they do to you if they got you. And that recaptures a little bit of the essence of Lovecraft. It's not perfect, but it's at least a start of an approach. It gets you partway there.
Let's get MacReady. Heads up. MacReady.
He looks better with the tuxedo and that. But we can get all our junk back. And I think that's really kind of what you have to do with difficult works of literature.
Well?
You just have to accept that you're not going to be able to adapt them directly as literature. And instead, to do something that captures some of their essence. Another film that did this pretty successfully was a film of a book called Naked Lunch, which actually I think was a pretty shoddy book. Maybe you might like it more than I did, but I did not enjoy that book at all. I've never quite made it all the way through. But Cronenberg did a film adaptation of it, and I think that he did a great job at making something good out of a book that was unfilmable and almost unreadable. See if we have any visitors queued up.
Huh?
We do. So let's give them. Bit of a gift.
It won't take long. Okay, that looked like it hurt.
Okay.
We're splitting all that, right?
Glad we checked. Because I generally am going to do my best to show you most of the combats that I get into in the game. I'm not going to always be successful, because occasionally I'll be visiting a settlement, and somebody will show up, or I will need to defend a settlement, and that's generally not going to be worth doing a recording for, particularly if I still have a lot of stuff that I want to do before the next recording. But generally speaking, I'm going to try and get as many of the combats as I can into these, because this is trying to be an honest recording of at least most of a game. Okay, so this is something I like. I like that by setting up this area, some of my settlers will just hang out there. Just hang out there and look official. There's not a lot that you can do with this space in this settlement. And I've occasionally tried to create raised platforms there and create ramps. I've created trading posts. I just think having a slightly raised platform with a chair is one of the better things to do here. Because it looks nice. All we have for today's Let's Play. We don't have any levels left to do. MacReady is still not quite happy enough.
Heads up.
Yet. Yeah. What? Here's that ammo.
How do you feel about us?
Doing pretty good. Starting to see eye to eye on a lot of things.
Hope it lasts.
Nothing else I needed.
Sure.
Yeah, so we're in a good place with him, but not quite good enough. And we have good armor, good weapon. We have a nice string of settlements here. And all of them are nicely linked up to the Mechanist Slayer via our trade bots. We haven't yet gone back to Vault 88, and maybe we should. But I'm going to probably wait maybe just a little bit further, or a little bit longer before I do that. We also have caught sight of a few more settlements that we haven't yet gone into. Yeah, we're in a good spot with this game. Anyhow, I'll see you in my next Let's Play. Bye-bye.